Good morning students. Today we will start with another topic of price elasticity of demand, that is numericals. Now for doing numericals we need to recapitulate all the formulas we had done previously. Now let us begin with the question and understand which formula we would be requiring. The first comes price of commodity X falls from rupees 5 per kg to rupees 4 per kg. Now let us learn to draft the question. Here P is equal to 5 and P1 is equal to 4. And the demand of consumer A for it rises from 4 kg to 6 kg. So Q is equal to 4 and Q1 is equal to 6. When we have these four values, we will use the formula price elasticity of demand is equal to minus P upon Q into change in Q upon change in P, right? Now let us substitute the values, and for change in Q and change in P, we need to calculate it. Change in P is equal to P1 minus P and change in Q is equal to Q1 minus Q. Here it comes to be 4 minus 5. So delta P is minus 1. Here it is 6 minus 4. So delta Q is equal to 2. Let us now substitute these values into this formula, or we can write ED is equal to minus of, substituting these values will come 5 upon 4 into 2 upon minus 1. It would cancel. The answer is 2.5. Based on this, we need to express our opinion regarding the nature of elasticity of demand. When ED is equal to 2.5, then we will comment that price elasticity of demand is greater than unity, that is greater than 1. Now comes the next question. If there is no change in the quantity demanded of commodity X, what will be the nature of price elasticity of demand? अब हम कह रहे हैं कि quantity demanded के अंदर कोई भी change नहीं आया, तो सीधी सी बात है, ये हमारी situation बन गई perfectly inelastic demand की. This is a situation of perfectly inelastic demand. I hope this is clear to you. Now let us move to the another question. So the next question comes, suppose that initial demand was 100 units. So it means for the solution we have Q is equal to 100. With the rise in price by rupees 5, it means change in P is 5, the quantity demanded decreases by 5 units. So change in Q is minus 5C. It is decreasing. It is rising. That is why it is positive and it is negative. Elasticity of demand is 1.2. Find out the price before change in demand. We have to find out this. So let us assume that P is equal to X. That is price before change in demand. Now let us directly put these values into the formula. We know ED is equal to minus of P upon Q into change in Q upon change in P. So 1.2 is equal to minus of P upon Q X upon 100 into change in Q minus 5 upon change in P 5. So 1.2 is equal to X upon 100. Thereby X is equal to 1.2 into 100, so X is equal to 120. So it means the price before change in demand is rupees 120. I hope this is clear to you. Now let us move to our next question. So the third question says that price of a commodity falls from rupees 4 to rupees 3 per unit. So we would say P is equal to 4 and P1 is equal to 3. As a result, the total expenditure on it rises from 200 to 300. Now see, we have not been given quantity, we have been given total expenditure. Total expenditure is 200 and it goes to 300. Now we know that total expenditure is equal to price into quantity. So quantity will be total expenditure upon price. So it means 200 divided by 4 is equal to 50 units and 300 divided by 3 is equal to 100 units, right? Now what we should do is we can opt either of the formulas, that is minus of P upon Q into change in Q upon change in P, or PED is equal to percentage change in quantity demanded upon percentage change in price. We have already done two questions with this formula. Now let us try out this formula. So it comes to be like percentage change in P is P1 minus P upon P into 100, and percentage change in quantity is Q1 minus Q upon Q into 100. So it comes to be 3 minus 4. 3 minus 4 upon 4 into 100, it means minus 1 by 4 into 100, it means minus 25%, because 1 by 4 is 25% and minus is carried. Here Q1 is this and this is Q. So 100 minus 50, 100 minus 50, the base is 50 into 100, so it means 50 upon 50 into 100, so it comes out to be 100%. This is minus of 25% because the price is decreasing, and this is positive of 100% because the quantity is rising. So let us put it into the formula. PED is equal to minus of percentage change in quantity demanded upon percentage change in price. Dear students, please note that you won't use these synonyms or shortcuts into the examination or your class test. You'll be writing the complete abbreviations. Okay, complete full forms, not abbreviations. So it comes out to be, that is, percentage change in quantity demanded is 100 minus and minus 25%. Percent se percent, 4 minus se minus. So it means PED is equal to 4. I hope this is clear to you. Now let's move on to our another question. So our next question says that the consumer buys 160 units of a good at a price of rupees 8 per unit. So it means P is equal to 8 and Q is equal to 160. Now how much quantity, price falls to rupees 6. So P1 is 6. How much quantity will the consumer buy at the new price? So it means we have to find out Q1. If PED is equal to minus 2. Now students, note here in the formula we will not prefix negative sign as PED is already given to be negative, that is minus 2. So let us put up the formula and the values. Here we have minus of P upon Q into change in Q upon change in P. But as we are given PED is equal to minus 2, so we will ignore this here. Only in the question where PED is given as negative. So it comes out to be minus 2 is equal to P upon Q, that is 8 upon 160 into change in Q. Here change in Q is equal to X minus 160 and change in P is equal to minus 2. 6 minus 8 is equal to minus 2. So change in Q, that is X minus 160 upon change in P, minus 2. 1 and 20. So it comes minus 2 is equal to X minus 160 upon minus 40. So minus 40 will go here. Minus 2 into minus 40 is equal to X minus 160, minus 80. So it comes minus minus plus positive 80 is equal to x minus 160, x is equal to 160 plus 80, it means 240. So at new price is 6, the consumer will buy how much? He will buy 240 units. I hope this is also clear to you. My dear students, take up your book, practice all the numericals. If you have any genuine doubt, please go to the comment section or call me up. I'll give you the solutions. Thank you and have a nice day.